Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly make text or graphics look like they're underwater on the bottom surface of a swimming pool. Notice how the text conforms to the contortions of the water and how the surface reflections remain bright and intact. I provided this image of a swimming pool so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. We're going to use this copy for our displacement map, which will distort our text based on the tonal values of the water. Since displacement effects look best when they're blurred, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur 3 pixels and then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to Layer and Duplicate Layer. Open your document list and click New. Type in Displacement and click OK. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop for easy access as a Photoshop file and then click Save. If you see this warning, click OK. Click the small X on the tab of the displacement file to close it. Now that we made a displacement map from the blurred background copy of the water, we can trash the layer. Open your horizontal type tool and make sure black and white are your respective foreground and background colors. If they are not, click this icon or press D on your keyboard. Choose a relatively heavy font. I'm using Bebas New Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll choose a size of 150 points, smooth, center alignment, and the color is black. Click on your document and type out your text. If you have more than one line of text, to adjust the space between the lines, highlight them and go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Drag the leading icon to the right or left to increase or decrease the space between the lines. To close the character panel, click the double arrowhead icon. To center your text, click your Move tool, press Ctrl or Command A to select it all, and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. We need to move the text down on the document. To do this, press the down arrow on your keyboard. Position your text so it's closer to the bottom. The reason we're doing this is because once we angle our entire image later, our text will look more centered. We also need to move the text 30 pixels to the left, since it'll be displaced 30 pixels to the right. Press and hold Shift as you press the left arrow key 3 times. Each time you press the left arrow, holding Shift moved it 10 pixels. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. You'll see this window if you're using version CC 2014. If you're using an earlier version, I'll show you what to do in a second. Click Convert to Smart Object. This allows us to change or edit our text without having to start from scratch. If you're using an earlier version of Photoshop, go to Layer, Smart Objects, and Convert to Smart Object. You know it's a smart object when you see this icon on the lower right corner of the thumbnail. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. For the horizontal and vertical scales, type in 30. Tick Stretch to Fit and repeat Edge Pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the Displacement document and click Open. Notice the text is now centered and the shapes of the individual characters have beautifully conformed to the reflections and curves of the water. Next, we'll make it look like it's underwater. Change the blend mode to overlay and reduce its opacity to 80%. If you want to change the text, double-click on the smart object to open it. Double-click the large T on the layer to highlight the text and type out your new words. Click the check mark and the small X on the tab of the smart object. Then, click Yes to save the changes. Notice the text instantly updated and retained all the filters and effects, as well as all the nuances of the water. I'll press Ctrl or Command Z to undo the last step. Let's angle our image in perspective. Make a composite snapshot by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Zoom out of your document by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to a bottom corner and drag it out until you're happy with the swimming pool's perspective. Then press Enter or Return. To see your document at 100%, press Ctrl or Command 1. The last step is to brighten our overall image. To do this, invoke Auto Levels by pressing Ctrl-Alt-L on Windows or Command-Option-L on a Mac. Then, press Enter or Return. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!